We all, I hope you're all fine at home, right? And today we are going to see general knowledge topics based on sports and games for grade 6. So what are all the topics to be covered in this unit are martial arts, mountaineering legends, sports stadiums around the world, female sports stars, rule bound board games and Asian games, right? I hope you all like sports and games very much, right? Yes. So you can get more knowledge about sports and games from this video. Okay, children? Yes. Now let us move into the video. The first topic is martial arts. The first topic is martial arts. So here, the description of the game is given. You have to read it and unscramble the letters. The name of the martial art is given down. You have to find what is that. Okay. So the term, first one is, the term means a skill or ability to do something this bare-handed fighting technique involves great muscular coordination and is also called wushu. Wushu. What is that? UNKGUF. So what is the name of this martial art? Can you see the picture? Yes. Find the answer, children. UNKGUF. How can you unscramble and find the word? Yes, you're right. The name of the game is Kung Fu. Name of the game is Kung Fu. KUNGFU. Right? And the second one. This technique trains the student in various holds and techniques to unbalance the opponent and make them fall. It is done by applying pressure to arm joints or to the neck to cause the opponent to yield. OUDJ. What is that? It's very easy. Yes, J-U-D-O, Judo. Bruce Lee, the popular martial artist, conceived this art, which means way of the intercepting fist. It basically depends on adapting according to the opponent's fighting style. What is that? Jeet Kune Do. This Jeet Kune Do. The spelling is JEETKUNEDO. Right? Yes. And the third one is Bruce Lee, the popular martial artist, conceived this art, which means the way of, sorry, fourth one. The words when translated mean art of kicking and punching. This Korean form borrows from many existing forms and depends on strong kicks and punches. What is that? It is Taekwondo. TAETKWON Kwon Do. Right? This is from Korea. This form means gentle art. It was developed among samurai warriors and makes use of few or no weapons. So what is this? It is Jiu-Jitsu. J-I-J-I-T. Sorry, J-U-J-I-T-S-U. Right? Jiu-Jitsu. This is an Indian martial art form chiefly practiced in South Indian states. Its focus on kicks, jumps and weapons, training as well as teaching healing methods. What is this? You can see the picture given there. Yes, it is Kalaripayattu. K-A-L-A-R-I. Kalari. P-A-Y-A-T-T-U. Kalaripayattu. Yes, Now we can move into the next topic. Yes, mountaineering legends. Mountaineering legends. Here we have three columns, column A, B and C. We have to rightly match A with B and AB with C, right? So match the information in three columns. So you have to put number 1 or A and 1 in column A, B and C. Yes? So first one is Tenzing Norgay. Tenzing Norgay. So the answer is E. The answer is E. Nepal. And in the next column it is seven. Reached the summit of Mount Everest on 29 May 1953. Yes, Tenzing Norgay, Nepal, reached the summit of Mount Everest on 29 May 1953. Second one, Lino Lacidelli. Answer is B or C, because both Italy, both comes as Italy. And you have to match it with column C. First person to reach K2 summit on 31st July 1954. In column A, it is about the people. And column B, about which country. And column C, what is their achievement, right? Yes. Next, Reinhold Messner. Reinhold Messner. Again, he also from Italy, right? He is the first climber in the world to reach all the 14 peaks above 8000 feet without supplemental oxygen. He did not take supplemental oxygen, right? Then, Edmund Hillary. Answer is, he's from New Zealand. And first climber to reach the summit of Mount Everest. He is the first climber to reach the summit of Mount Everest. Right? Then, Carlos Carsolio. He belongs to Mexico. His achievement is second youngest mountaineer to climb all 14 peaks above 8000 feet. Who is the first? Yes, it is Reinhold Messner. And Carlos Carsolio was the second person to climb all 14 peaks above 8000 feet, right? And Juanito Oyarzabal. Juanito Oyarzabal. So he is from Spain and he is the first person to conquer the three summits twice, Mount Everest, K2 and Kanchenjunga, right? Then Andrew Locke is from Australia and he was awarded the Medal of the Order of Australia 2011 for his efforts and achievements in the field of mountaineering. Next, last one, Radek Jaros. He is from Czech Republic. He was the first in his country to climb the Kanchenjunga along with Martin Minarik in 2002. Understood, children? Yes. This topic is about sports stadiums around the world. So first one is you have to match the columns with their description. That is, the stadiums are given here and you have to match it with their description. National Aquatic Center, Beijing, China. It is known as the Water Cube. This is where Michael Phelps won 8 Olympic gold medals in 2008. Second one, Panathinaik Stadium, Athens, Greece. So it is in, it is the modern Olympics started here in this U-shaped stadium, which has been made like the one that was built for 330 BCE Panathinaik Games. The float, Marina Bay, Singapore. It is the world's largest floating stage. Olympia Stadion, Munich, Germany. It is made for the 1972 Summer Olympics in a pit formed by bombs dropped on Munich during World War II. And Ericsson Globe, Stockholm, Sweden. It is the national indoor stadium of Sweden and is the largest hemispherical building in the world. And sixth one is National Stadium, Kaohsiung, Taiwan. It is the first stadium in the world to provide power using solar energy. And Soccer City, Johannesburg, South Africa. It is the stadium located on the site of an old gold mine, is the largest in the African continent. Camp Nou, Barcelona, Spain. And this is the biggest stadium in Europe, built in 1950s, which is given here, the picture, number 8. Yes? And our next topic is female sports stars. Female sports stars. So you have to match the stars with their description. So Mithali Raj, she is our Indian women's cricket team captain, highest run scorer in the women's international cricket, and she has won Padma Shri and Arjuna award. Yes, can you see? This is the first picture. And second, Deepika Kumari. Deepika Kumari, she is the archer of 2010 Commonwealth Games gold medal winner. PV Sindhu, she is the Indian national badminton champion, first Indian woman to win the 2017 Korean Open Series, silver medal winner at 2018 Commonwealth Games. Anjali Bhagwat, fourth one is Anjali Bhagwat. She is the shooter. Can you see in fourth picture? Yes. Shooter, 2003 World Cup winner, 12 gold and 4 silver medals in Commonwealth Games. Arjuna and Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna awardee. Fifth one, Sania Mirza. We all know her, right? Very famous personality. She is India's first woman to be seeded in number one in Grand Slam. India's first woman to be seeded number one in a Grand Slam. Saina Nehwal, badminton player, bronze medal winner at London Olympics 2012, Padma Shri and Padma Bhushan awardee. Bula Chaudhary, first woman swimmer to swim across sea channels in 5 continents, Padma Shri and Arjuna awardee. MC Mary Kom, known as Million Rupee Baby, Olympic bronze winner, 5-time boxing world champion. Our next topic is rule bound. Here you are provided with a help box. Write the name of the sport which the rule is associated using the help box. Rules are given here. You have to find out which game it is, right? The opponent's grip should be palm to palm with thumb knuckles visible. It is arm wrestling. It is arm wrestling. Next. Overarm serves are not allowed. Overarm serves are not allowed. It is badminton. Each team can have a maximum of 5 players on the court at any time. Substitutions can be made as many as times as the team wishes in a game. It is basketball. The only method of attack is punching with a clenched fist, and you may not strike below the belt, in the kidneys, or the back of the opponent's head or neck. It is boxing. Players can use only up to 14 clubs. It is golf. When a goal is scored, the team's change ends. In this way, it helps to equalize any ground or weather advantages. It is polo. Until the referee signifies the start of the match, wrestlers are to crouch with fists on the floor. It is sumo wrestling. Each team can hit the ball up to 3 times before the ball is returned. It is volleyball. The next topic is board games. The next topic is board games. You can read the clues and name the board games using the help box. First one, often described as the fast dealing property trading game, this game originated in America. Moving around the game board, the players buy, develop, trade properties, collect rents and buy hotels, trying to stay financially strong and force opponents into bankruptcy. What game it is? It is Monopoly. It is Monopoly, your third option. And second one is, this is played between two players, code maker and code breaker. The goal is to make a code that the other player cannot break. It is Mastermind. And third one, this is a murder mystery where the players are characters in a thriller moving about in a Tudor mansion in England. The board comprising rooms, corridors and secret passages becomes the arena where the mystery is solved. The name of the game is Cluedo. And fourth one, the players in this game go through their life journey right from infancy to happy old age by landing only in the happy and good stops of life and earning points. The players move on the track by spinning a wheel. So the name of the game is Game of Life. And fifth one, this is a test of physical suppleness on a mat with 4 rows of colorful circles, and the players move about placing their limbs on the correct circle as decided by the spinning wheel. Losing balance leads to disqualification. What is the name of this game? Yes, it is Twister. So let us move into the next topic and the last topic of this chapter. It is Asian Games. Which continent we all belong to, children? Yes, we belong to Asian continent. So answer the following questions about the Asian Games using the clues given in the help box. So when and where were the first Asian Games held? It is 1951, Delhi. At what frequency are the games organized? Every four years. Where were the 2014 games held? 2014 games held in Incheon, South Korea. Next, what is the other name by which the games are known? It is Asiad. It is Asiad. How many countries participated in the first Asian Games? Totally 11 countries participated. Which nations are allowed to participate in these games? Only Asian countries. What was the symbol of the first Asian Games? Rising sun with interlocking rings. Which governing body organizes the Asian Games? It is Olympic Council of Asia, OCA. In which year were the equestrian event introduced in the games? It is in the year 1982. Which country hosted the 2018 Asian Games? It is Indonesia. Children, I hope you have understood about the games and all the descriptions, rules for certain games. Yes, and you would have learned the rules and description of the game, and you would have found which game it is, right? I hope you have enriched your knowledge about games through this video. Let us meet in the next video with a new topic, right? So stay home, stay safe, and learn well, children. Okay, and thank you. Bye.